Well, hello one and all, and welcome to our short on handling exceptions. Now, when things go wrong in our programs, we can handle them and hopefully correct our program as it runs. And I have here a program called distances.py that I'll admit is a little bit buggy. Now, what I hope distances.py will do is take this dictionary of distances and actually convert each of them to meters when I ask for the distance of some given spacecraft. So for instance, if I entered in Voyager 1 down here on line 11, I would hope to convert 163 here to meters and then print however many meters Voyager 1 is away from Earth. Now I use this function called convert down here, which simply takes some given number of AU, astronomical units, and converts it then to meters using this constant that converts between, in this case, AU and meters. But I don't think my problem here is with convert. I think it's up here in main. So let's go ahead and try this program out. I'll go ahead and run Python of distances.py. And here, I'll try to enter in Voyager 1. And hopefully I should see the number of meters Voyager 1 is away from Earth. I'll hit enter here, and I seem to have gotten a memory error. Now, why might this be the case? Well, you might notice that Voyager 1 has a distance of 163 AU, but this in particular is written as a string, not a number. And if I were to access this value, 163, the string, and pass it into convert, well, this star syntax means something else entirely from what it means with numbers. When I take a string, let's say the string 163, and multiply it, let's say, with this star operator by whatever this huge number is, I'm essentially saying take this 163 as text and repeat it however many times this is down here, which is more than enough to kind of overflow the memory I have here in my computer, and I don't want to be doing that down below. So what should I do instead? Well, we've seen these functions to convert between, in this case, text and numbers. And you'll get messy data like this all the time. So it's our job to make sure we're getting the data we want to using functions like these here. Well, ideally, I want to convert, let's say, this text 163 or 136 into some number. And I can use a function like float to do just that. Here, I seem only to have integers, but I can be more general and say, let's just use floats. I'll take maybe 163.2 AU in the future, for instance. So I'll take float here, and I'll maybe first pass as input the value we hoped to get from our dictionary. And I'll store that as a value called AU. And I'll then convert the value of AU to meters in this case. So to be clear, we're going to access the text 163 using this line of code here. We're going to convert it to a float using float and store that in the variable AU. We'll then convert AU to some number of meters and print that number of meters out down below. I'll go ahead now and run Python of distances.py, and I'll type in Voyager 1 again, and now we'll see that Voyager 1 seems to be some very large number of meters away. So that seems to work here, but what still could go wrong? Our data, I would argue, is still pretty messy. If I look here at Pioneer 10, I see the text 80 AU. And that doesn't seem to be something that could convert to a float. In fact, let's try it. I'll type Python of distances.py, and I'll type in Pioneer 10. And so here is our value error. We could not convert this string 80 AU to a float. Python says, how can A and U be a number? I don't quite know how to convert those. So it raises, in this case, a value error. So this is an exception that we can handle within our main function. And in Python, the convention is simply try to do something, and if things go wrong, handle the case where it doesn't go as expected. So to try to handle this exception here, why don't we try using this block of code called try and accept block. As I said before, I can really just try to do the thing I want to do, which is convert, let's say, this distance to a float and store it, in this case, in this variable called AU. But of course, things can go wrong, as we just saw before, and we should be mindful of how we handle the exception that could occur. So if I want to make a new, let's say, handler, a way of handling this exception, I can use an except block here, and I'll type except, which is a keyword in Python, followed by the name of the exception that I think could happen. And in this case, we saw a value error. So I could, within the indented block here, try to handle this value error. Maybe instead of showing the error to the user, I could maybe instead just print something a little more friendly. I could say, maybe can't convert whatever the value we had here was, distances, spacecraft, to a float, just like this. And then, because we can't really convert it to a float, I'll go ahead and end my program by calling return. So let me separate this here for logic's sake and style. Here, I'm taking input and asking for, in this case, let's say Pioneer 10. Now we'll try to convert the value for Pioneer 10, which is 80 AU, to a float, but in the case that we get a value error, we'll instead run this code indented within this block here and not show the error to the user. Let's try this here. I'll run Python of distances.py. I'll type in Pioneer 10, and we'll see we can't convert 80 AU to a float. And maybe for style, let me go ahead and put some single quotes around here just to do this, Pioneer 10. And now it's clear that our string was 80 AU. We couldn't convert that string to a float because, of course, it has AU for astronomical units inside of its value here. So this is one exception we have handled thanks to try and except. But often there might be more than one exception that could happen for any given line of code. Let's take a look at our line of code here inside of this try block. What other things do you think could go wrong with this line of code that could raise an exception? Well, what I have in my mind is that I have here 5 spacecraft. But what if I asked for one that wasn't on this list? Would this code work or would it not? Let's try it out. I'll say Python of distances.py, and maybe I'll enter in the James Webb Space Telescope, which is not part of my dictionary up above. I'll go ahead and hit enter. And now I see another exception, one called a key error, which means I can't find this value, James Webb Space Telescope, inside of my dictionary, or can't find this key, rather. So it turns out that this line of code could trigger a value error and a key error, depending on the input the user gives me. And if I want to handle those exceptions differently, I can certainly do that. Within this try and except block, I can go ahead and add a new block here to handle, in this case, the key error we see down below. So to be clear, when I put this line of code inside try, I'm kind of listening or waiting for being ready to handle any exceptions I might come across. In this case, if those exceptions are a key error or a value error, I'll run the code indented in either of these blocks, respectively. So if it's a key error, what could we tell the user? We could probably tell them that the spacecraft is just not in the dictionary. So I'll say here, print, and maybe can't, maybe actually let's type, spacecraft, whatever you typed in, is not in dictionary, just like this. Bit of a more friendly message than the key error we saw down below. I'll similarly return saying my program is done if we can't find the spacecraft you're looking for, and let's see what happens down below. I'll type Python of distances.py. I'll then type in James Webb Space Telescope, hit enter, and we'll see that quote unquote James Webb Space Telescope is not in the dictionary. So here we've created 2 handlers for these various exceptions that could be raised, key errors and value errors. Now you could, if you wanted to, try to handle all kinds of exceptions within one block. Something like except exception might work. But in general, it's good practice to be as specific with your exceptions as you possibly can. It's good practice as programmers to actually know what kinds of exceptions could be raised as well. In this case here, there are really 2 kinds of exceptions that could happen here. One, of course, was the value error, and the other was the key error. So as you write code, try to anticipate these exceptions and hopefully write some code to handle when you might encounter those exceptions instead. So this here was our short on handling exceptions. We'll see you next time.